Lord, we just come to you tonight just to give you honor and praise and glory. Lord, we are so thankful for all that you do in our lives. And Father, tonight I just ask that you would just ask for your presence with us in a mighty and powerful way. Thank you, Lord, for inhabiting our praises. Thank you, Lord, for just blessing us as we bless you. We pray, Lord, that our praises would be acceptable to you, and more than that, pleasurable in your ear. Lord, we just love you. We praise you, Lord. We love you. Praise you.
We bless you, Lord. We bless you, Jesus. We bless you, Father. You're wonderful, God. You're beautiful, Lord. You're wonderful, majestic, God.
Yes,
you are awesome, Lord. We bless you, Father. We bless you, Lord. You are wonderful, Jesus. You are wonderful, God. You are God of power. You are our God of mighty power, God. You defend our cause, O Lord. You take us by the hand and you guide us, Lord. You are awesome and wonderful, Father. We bless you, Jesus. We bless you, God. There is no one like you, Lord. There is no one like you, Lord. There is nothing that can compare to you, O God. We bless you, Lord. We bless you, Father. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, God. You're beautiful, Lord. We have no words, God, to thank you, Lord, to exalt you, Father, to say that you are wonderful, that you are beautiful, God, that there is no God like you, Lord. We worship you, Father. We honor your name, God. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you for your faithfulness, Lord. Thank you because your word is a yes and a amen. Your promises are a yes and a amen, God. Thank you, Lord, because we can trust in you, Father. You will never let us down, God. You fight our battles. You go before us, Lord. You destroy, Lord, the plans of our enemies, Father, that come against us, God. You stand, Lord. You stand for your children, God. We thank you, Lord. We bless you, Father. We bless you, Lord. You go ahead of us. You go ahead of any of the plans of the enemy, Father. You know them in advance, Father. You lead us. You show us. You give us the wisdom, Lord, to avoid, Father, all those attacks, Father, in the name of Jesus, to come out in victory, God. There is no one like you, Father. There is no one like you, Lord. We seek your face, God. We seek you, Lord. We love you, Father. We honor your name. We bless you. We bless you. We bless you. There is no one like you, God. There is no one like you, Lord. We're blessed to have you as our God, our Lord, our Father, our Defender, God. We're blessed, Lord. We're blessed because you bless us with your presence in our lives, Father. We bless you, Lord. There is no one like you, Jesus. You are God, Lord.
Yes,
Lord. Oh, Rababahanda.
We are.
Thank you.
Vision, which he does take me through at times. And what's amazing for me is this morning, you know, you read something 100 times for the first time. Right. You know, I heard someone on a show, someone say this wish. They said, if you had one wish in the world, asking a billionaire, what would it be? And it was an impossible wish he had. And you know what it was? Seeing his favorite movie again for the first time. That's an impossible wish, unobtainable for money. But do you know the word of God is just that?
Amen. Yeah.
It's just that forever and ever. The word, his written word, not even the rhema word, the logos, it's like reading it for the first time. And most will never read it for the first time, so they can't ever come back and read it again for the first time. I don't ask you ever, hey, who's ever, but haven't you experienced that?
Yes.
You know, how many times have we probably read the Gospels? For me, it's a while, and he's been taking me through, but this time it's different. I'm looking at Jesus, talking to him as I'm reading, and I'm finding that the Gospels, as full as they are so incomplete. They're just a sketch of who he is. He leaves the rest for us to get to know. But the cool thing is, you know, when he was being set up by, you know, the end, he had this phrase. He said, the script, John says that he loved his disciples to the highest degree.
And I realized, I read that for the first time again and said, nobody on the planet knows what that means. Nobody. We may know great love and amazing love, but his love was to the highest degree. And I look, and you consider the universe. I was sitting, Elva and I were sitting on the deck today, and I'm looking, and I'm thinking, he loved to the highest degree. And in his love, someplace beyond, just beyond our reach in the natural, is this thing called freedom. We've defined freedom as freedom to choose what we want to do, freedom. But man, no matter how free we get, we still have governments that don't free us. They conform us. Let's just be honest. And we have a certain amount of freedom. And he said, look at the squirrel running. Listen to the birds chirping. I said, how can we ever experience that type of freedom? We'd have to, you know, pay off our debt, sell our house, and run off into the woods, and we'd have to isolate ourselves, and that's not freedom. Get off the grid, as they say. And I'm looking at the squirrel, and I'm saying, oh my gosh, that squirrel lives in total freedom. He's just a squirrel, and he can hang out with any squirrel he wants. He's still just a squirrel in his community, in order, and there's a perfect order. You understand? And I'm looking, and I said, oh my gosh, you had some type of original design for that for us. He says, that you will realize in an age to come. And he took me as far as to say, even the planets, you know, planets we think in our terms are so far apart from each other. Well, not when the universe exists in the breadth of his hand, or a telescope looks at another galaxy. This sun is 4 light years away from the nearest star, and yet it's comprised in a galaxy, and they all do exactly what they're supposed to do. They're in a community, in other words. Because the word says that the stars utter their voice all the time, and their voice goes throughout the earth, but it's not heard. But their voice still goes out throughout the earth. The stars. They're there's a perfect community. And guess what we get to do? We come into a perfect body whose government is on his shoulders. There is a freedom that I'm not sure we've tasted, that has a perfect order to it. Many may disagree with me, but all you have to do is look at creation. Dogs don't have governments, but they're governed. What? By their nature. Same thing with the squirrels, the birds, the planets, the universe. They're all governed by the nature that they're created with. And you know what? We were created with a nature that was perfect until a fall, and yet I said, Lord, what sets us apart? He says, besides my love for you, created in my image, in that freedom I didn't put you under, I gave you dominion over. He didn't give the squirrels dominion over, he gave us dominion. But that's what is about to be restored in the ages to come is, it's incomprehensible. Would say, well, this sounds far out. Is it? Does he not restore us back into him who has all power and authority in heaven and earth, whose government is upon his shoulders, and we're in him? Think about when we bless him and we're in his holy place and we're looking at him face to face. That's the only who can stop you from that? What law can be passed that prohibits you from that? Daniel, it couldn't affect Daniel. How many others did it not affect? Ashak, Meshach, Abednego? That place has perfect order because of, you know what? And it's no mistake that Dwight's here. Because of this amazing love, because he loves us to the highest degree. But what does that mean? I think we could go to eternity and eternity be over, and we still may not be able to answer that question fully. You know what I mean? It should make our minds go, I can't grab it. That's right. That's how much he loved us. And all things, all authority in heaven and earth is given unto him, and we're in him. How can we? Thank you, Lord. Lord Jesus. Amazing love. You're King of all. How can it be that you, my King, would die for me?
Amazing.
and everything in it, the world and its inhabitants, belong to the Lord. For he laid its foundation on the seas and established it on the rivers. Who may ascend the mountain of the Lord? Who may stand in his holy place? The one who has clean hands and a pure heart, who has not set his mind on what is false, and who has not sworn deceitfully. He will receive blessings from the Lord and righteousness from the God of his salvation. Such is the generation of those who seek him, who seek the face of the God of Jacob. Lift up your heads, you gates. Raise up ancient doors. Then the King of glory will come in. Who is the King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty. The Lord mighty in battle. Lift up your heads, you gates. Raise up ancient doors. Then the King of glory will come in. Who is he? This King of glory, the Lord of hosts. He is the King of glory. You are the King of glory. You are the King of glory. And we lift up your name, O God. We lift up your name, O Jesus. We bless you and honor your name, O God. You are the King of glory, Lord. You are the Holy, the Holy, the Holy, the Holy One of Israel. You are the King. You are mighty in war. You are the mighty warrior, God. You are our King, our Lord. You are the Lord, our King Jesus. You are the King of kings and the Lord of lords. We bless you and we thank you because your mighty grace, your mighty power, your Holy Spirit in us, your power, your grace working in us, Lord, cleansing our minds from thoughts that are false, oh God, and aligning our minds to your mind, our thoughts to your thoughts. This is the work of your Spirit in us. This is the promise and the grace that he who started the work in us will bring it to perfection. It is your grace. It is your love. And we ask your grace, greater and greater grace each day, Lord. We need you, God. As we seek your face, to see you, Lord, see you as in a mirror, to reflect your thoughts, your words, you and not us. We want to see you, Lord, face to face, and be the reflection of your glory. As we keep walking, you keep cleansing our hands from taking anything that does not belong to us, from touching anything, Lord, that is unclean, from keeping us from works that are of the flesh. You cleanse our hands, O God, that we will not carry things that we should not carry, because those are for you to carry, and not fight with our own strength, in our own wisdom, but in yours. You, the one that fights our battles and go before us. We want to raise clean hands before you, O Lord. We want to have clean hands, clean minds, your thoughts, not ours. We want to love with your merciful love, nor our judgmental love, nor our love with criticism in it, not the kind of love that hurts without a need to hurt, but with your love, with your thoughts, with what you see in the hearts of people and not of what we see in the outside. We want to walk in the straight path that you show before us. We want to follow your steps. We want to follow your thoughts. We want to follow the works you prepare for us beforehand so that we can walk in them, Lord. We want to follow you with all our hearts, our minds, our thoughts, our souls, our bodies, everything in us, God, immerse in you, Jesus, in your spirit, Lord, in your grace and in your love and your wisdom, God, to learn how to be quiet when we need to be quiet and keep quiet and be silent before the Lord and wait expectantly that he will work things out. Help us trust. Help us know what's the right thing to do in every occasion, in every moment, God. We want to follow your lead, because yours is the wisdom, yours is the power, and yours is the glory. And we bless you, Lord, and we honor you, God. We thank you for the fear of God in our hearts. We thank you for the love of God in our hearts. We thank you, Lord, because we empty ourselves out of anything, Lord, any iniquity, uncleanness. And we're covered and dressed with clean garments by the blood of Jesus, our King of glory. We bless you, Lord. We bless you, Father. Thank you for your grace. Thank you for your love. Thank you, Jesus. We love you. We love you.
Father, Lord,
Korea baba hashkiri diri vendiri handi kere vedeshki. Korea baba handashkiri adiri ha. Kore vedeshkiri adiri vandiri handi kere diri vende. Your words, O God. Your words that speak light to a certain situation. Your word that speak life to a certain situation. Kere vehesh kere dere vendere hende kere vahandi. Kokora baba hashkindare dere vehesh kiri diri vandiri aha. Kora baba dishkiri ahandi kere vendere vende he. He kere dere vehesh kiri avahakandare dere vende hika kari avashke kere deshki. You have given us this land, O God. Kere vende shkiri adarabandi hikiri avabashkiri adarambandi. Kere dereshki. And your word is true, and your promises are a yes and a amen. And your power is over any other power, God. There is no one like you, O Lord. Your power, your love, your grace, your word is sufficient. It's enough to change situations, O God. And we speak that light to a certain situation, O Lord. There is power in your name. There is power in your name, O God. There is power in your name, O Lord. There is power in you, Jesus. There is power in your resurrection from the cross. Oh Lord, there is power, oh God. There is power, oh Jesus. There is power, God, to bring those people out of that pit. Hey, there is power to bring them out of those prisons. There is power to bring them out of that deception in the name of Jesus Christ. You have created them, Lord. You have created them, man and women, to form a family and live together, to be one in you. Hokora bahandish kinda rabadi hikia kara dari hi kerebesh kita ni bahanda kere di shkiri baha. In anything that is a way out of your law, your spiritual law, your creation, your design must come into an alignment. In the name of Jesus, there is power in your name. Hekere mahach kender yeri yeri abandir yeri bahanda kere dere beshki. Hekere yeri bahanda kere ki. Hara mahach kiri yeri bahanda kere dere beshki. Ah, what the enemy did to destroy a life and generations, God, it will transform it. Because he is. His is the power. His is the power. His is the glory. And his promise. Children and those young people, all people, anyone, God, that has been in this deception of homosexuality, lesbianism, any kind of thing that is not in alignment with your plan and purpose for their lives, each one of our lives will not prosper. In the name of Jesus. Hekere veheshkinda. Kora bahande ria bahanda. You cut those chains. You destroy them. And you send our enemies. Hokoria bahande shkinda radiri bahanda. Hekere dere where they belong. Hekere veheshkinda rabadihikanda. In the depths of the cell. The destruction where they will not come back again. We send protection to these lives. We send people. We send help. We send prophets. We send mothers. We send fathers. We send people around them to guide them in your light. Because for you there is nothing impossible. We're speaking light, 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 as they wake up and they realize who they are in you, Jesus. And they see you in dreams, and they see you in visions, and they see you and they touch by you, Lord. Because in the midst of consequences because of sin, you always speak mercy. You always speak words of hope. Repent, repent, repent. Change your ways, change your ways. Turn to God, see His face. He has the power, He has the love to heal you, to release you, to change you, to transform you, and to take you to your destiny, to take you to your purpose, to take you to His arms, to take you to be the person that you were designed at the beginning to be, in the name of Jesus. And we go to those places in hell where the enemy has been planning to destroy even children that has not been born yet. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, those plans will not prosper. I'm putting them a stop right now. In the name of Jesus, protection of angels, protection of the power of God, rain, 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 rain of the Spirit, rain, rain, a thirst, a hunger for you, O God, even when they are in their mother's womb, a hunger and thirst for you, nothing less but you. Kere behesh kinda yabahan.
Thank you. Thank you.
of your mighty deeds we sing. We give all honor to you who sits upon the throne, the Lamb, our Lord, the great and mighty King. Your majesty.
aceite. That he loves us to the highest degree. It has got to be something big. It transcends every dimension, every created. Keeps creating. Every time he breathes out stars, you know? It's amazing.
How?
And he names them.